So there's been a pretty important change to how the Settings app deals with your Apple ID in iOS 10.3. So before you had all these different places where you had to look for your Apple ID, mostly at your iCloud account. But now if you go to Settings in iOS 10.3, at the top of Settings you can see your name and one place to get to all the different things that your Apple ID is connected to. So if we tap on it and go into it, you'll see your picture there at the top, your name, the email address that is your Apple ID email address. It's the one you use to log in. And then you see all this different information about your Apple ID. You've got your name, phone numbers, and email all associated with your Apple ID there at the very top. And you can go in and this is where you can change all of this. Take a look at it. You also can see information about getting updates from Apple there at the bottom. You've got password and security. So you can, this is where you can change your password, change your security questions, or much more importantly, you should be using two-factor authentication. The only reason I'm not here is this is just a demo account. I create these demo throwaway accounts all the time to demonstrate things. But for my main account, you can bet I certainly am using two-factor authentication. And then you've got a rescue email address, which is very important to have. If you have a backup email address somewhere, you can use that as well for security. Then you've got information like payment and shipping where you can set your address for things. You've got then iCloud. This is where all the information that used to be under the iCloud tab here in Settings is located. So you have all the different services you're using for iCloud, whether they're turned on or off, and different ways you can modify them, like going to Photos and determine which parts of iCloud you're using for Photos. You've got your storage there at the top. And then you've got the iTunes and App Store settings here. So you can see it's all in one place. So now, you know, before you could possibly, you know, have to look in two different places for iTunes stuff and for iCloud stuff. You still notice can change it. I can tap here and I can use a different Apple ID for iTunes, which some people need to do. But for the most part, you should be using the same one. And then you've got family sharing next if you're using that. And then you have all the different devices that you've registered to your Apple ID. So for instance, I can go and take a look at this one here and I can, if I would verify my identity there, I can go in and kick that old device, maybe one I've sold, off of my Apple ID there. On the left side, if you go down, you'll see where you normally saw iCloud settings. It's gone. It's not there anymore. iTunes and App Store is still there. And notice it takes you to exactly the same screen that you saw before. So you still have that available and you still have Wallet and Apple Pay there as a separate thing for devices that support using Apple Pay. So you've got that there as well. But for the most part, Apple consolidated everything having to do with your Apple ID here in Settings under this heading here, which makes things a lot more straightforward and drives home the importance of your Apple ID, which is also your ID for iCloud, for iTunes, for everything Apple. So it's all in one place now in iOS 10.3, and you can get to it easily. If you haven't checked it out yet, it's probably a good time to go through it, check it out. If you're not using two-factor authentication, this is a really good time to turn it on because everybody should be using that.